What up, man? Y'all already know. It's your boy Red, BMB Red, DJ Red. I got plenty names, man, but it's Red, R-E-D-D, man. That's two D's like a white girl's tits. You already know.
I mean a nice white girl. If you ain't got that, we ain't talking to you.
Yeah, you gotta be a nice white girl, man.
But how you doing today, my brother?
Man, I'm good, bro. Just chilling, man.
You know what I'm saying? You know, long time no see. You know what I'm saying? It's good to see you, dog. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. See you doing good, bro. Man, see you out here.
Man, I'm trying to, man. This COVID shit done fucked up a lot of my traveling, so.
Coronavirus! Nah, but for real, man, yeah, the COVID shit slowed down a lot of people's shit. Yeah, you know, yeah. So hopefully it passed. Hopefully the world opens back up. How you been doing besides the corona shit? You know anybody that caught it, or you been good?
Shit, you know what? I don't know nobody personally, but I be seeing people with it or whatever, you know what I'm saying, saying that they got it. But
yeah,
I've been chilling, bro. I've been really chilling. I picked up DJing. I'm like, fuck it.
Yeah, I be seeing you back in the bars and the clubs again, bro. That's what's up.
These DJs hate it, too. I'm telling you, they hate it.
There's a lot of people going to hate you, yeah, Red. You out here, bro.
They like, how is you getting jobs this fast? You just started, no, you got to do this. I'm like, man, I'm just me, bro. You know?
I feel like we operate on the same wavelength.
Yeah.
Because we move differently and shit just happens good for us. Like, you know, we put out good shit in the world and good shit comes back.
Man, definitely, bro. You gotta put out that good energy. If not, you're gonna get bad energy sometimes. Like karma, bro.
Karma comes around real quick.
I believe in that.
So, where you grow up at?
Man, I'm originally from Chicago. I moved here when I was like one, so, you know what I mean? I didn't really have a choice on where I was gonna live or whatever, you know? And when you a kid or whatever, my bad. Shit, when you a kid or whatever, you know, you just come in, you move. But shit, man, when we moved here, we bounced around, bro. I lived on 45th and Lloyd for a while. We moved to 44th and Center. We moved to the South Side. I lived in West Dallas for a minute, so. You know,
so every little part of Milwaukee you've been on,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah.
So when you start doing music?
I started doing music probably like eighth grade. I remember I ain't doing an assignment, so my teacher was like, you know what I'm saying, you finna get an F. I'm like, man. I'm like, man, you know what I'm saying, can I write something? He like, go ahead, but you gotta perform it in front of the class. You know what I'm saying? So I wrote something about like science class or some shit like that. And then, you know what I mean? From there, shit, I got into high school. I met my boy Polo. Shit, you know what I mean? We just hooked up, man, linked like that. So I've been doing music, like, seriously, probably since I was about, like, 17. I dropped my first mixtape, History in the Making. So shit, from there, just was dropping shit, bro.
And I know you like to travel, and I know you've been on a few tours. So what's your favorite show you've done so far? Favorite place you've been to on some music-related stuff?
Music-related, bro, my favorite place I've been to was probably Denver.
I fuck with Denver. Denver. I'll see you next month.
Yeah, man, Denver, you know. Denver be lit, bro. Like, I done performed there like two or three times, but like, just the whole vibe there be crazy. I had went on a tour. You know what I'm saying? We did like an 8-city tour, so that was one of the stops, man. Denver, bro. Denver be showing so much love. I love Denver.
It's like a whole different kind of lifestyle out there. Like, people are, well, especially from us being from Milwaukee, it's like we ain't really friendly type people.
Real.
Compared to like people out there, they'll say hi and ask you how your day was and really care.
Yeah, on the real. Like, hey, how you doing?
You're like, okay. Yeah. I thought I was going to swing off on you for a second. You said, what up? Kind of too nice. I didn't know what to expect.
Nah, but like Denver was lit, bro. Denver, New Mexico was cracking. Like, all these places people don't go to, man. South Dakota was cracking.
I'm actually in South Dakota. I'll see you next month as well.
Oh, where? Oh,
yeah, you know, I'm doing a couple stops. You know, Famous be out here too. I'm trying to get like you, bro. I be jealous as a bitch, bro. Like, you don't take Famous nowhere. Like,
oh, bro, man, we better
bring
together,
your cameraman
bro.
With you, bro.
I got you, bro.
Don't hurt me like that.
We're gonna do it, bro.
But sure. So you've done music in quite a few places. How's it different from Milwaukee?
As far as what, like?
Just like how the people there and just the whole, I guess, a scene in other cities compared to Milwaukee's music scene.
You know what? I think, like, Milwaukee, like, music scene is definitely on the rise right now. I think it's, like, when you, like, somewhere new and you somebody new that, like, not from there, they, like, more attached to you than, like, versus, like, seeing you every day. You know what I'm saying? Like, you'd be like, man, I went to high school, dude. All right. All this guy's doing music? So it's like that. Like, when you go out of town, it's like they definitely show you plenty love, bro. Like a lot more love than your city would. But, you know, that's just what comes with it, bro. And everybody think too that like it's only Milwaukee. When people are like, man, only Milwaukee, they haters. Like,
oh no, there's haters everywhere. Like
the same stuff we going through in Milwaukee, they going through in Atlanta and wherever. Bro.
In Detroit, all kinds of shit.
You from there? You just, you know what I mean? You gotta just get it in, bro.
All right, so I think it was a couple summers ago you did a acting show.
Yeah, for sure.
Where was it located?
Man, I did.
It was the one at the Paps, or was it the Riverside?
Did,
the Paps.
Yeah. I did the Paps, man. I did a play, a stage play, called Agape Love. I played a crooked deacon. You know what I'm saying? I was stealing from the church or whatever, man. So
I don't picture you stealing, but you could be a crooked deacon in the past life. I don't picture you being a thief though. You know, you be crooked doing some other shit. You know, but like
yeah. So like from there, man, I just been you know, I did that, man. I had a small part in the 53206 movie. I did a film called Welcome to the Trap. Man, just been trying to get it in with the acting, bro. Trying to do everything, not just music. Do whatever, you know what I mean? Music, DJing, acting, trying to do everything, bro.
So what was your favorite, like, most favorite experience from the acting?
Man, probably the play at the Paps. Like, I was like one of the main characters.
There had to be a lot of people there too.
Yeah, it was plenty of people, bro. Like, it was like packed. And Nesby. I don't know if y'all know who that is, but y'all need to look her up, bro. She got songs with Patti LaBelle. She got a song with Jadakiss. Like, she won a Grammy, everything. She was actually in the play, so I got a chance to, like, you know, just chill with her.
Rub shoulders with somebody big.
Yeah, so it was cool, bro.
That sounds dope, bro.
Yeah, it was definitely.
What was it like working on the 53206 movie?
Yeah, 53206. I had, like, a small role. Shout out to Miss Kim Productions. But, man, it was cool, bro. Just the whole vibe. Like, just being around, just actually being on a real set. Like, the people who shot it, they was, like, from L.A. They came here with the red cameras. They had security everywhere. You know what I mean? It was cool.
We got to have security in Milwaukee. Yeah, at least they didn't recognize where they was at, you know?
You definitely do, bro. But, man, it was a good experience, bro, just to, you know, be around people. And just, man, those vibes, bro, catching those vibes.
All right, so switching it up a little bit. Yeah. What is it like being a baby mama bandit?
Man, it's
I don't have a baby mama, so I feel safe around you. So
yeah.
If I did though, we interviewing shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't let me have no kids. You can't come back around.
Oh man, you know, man, the baby mama bandit. Man, it's been wild, bro. People see me like it started off, man. Shout out to my homie Dollars. Like, he was like, you know, he was the original baby mama bandit. And he like, yeah, man, you know what I'm saying? I'm giving you the name. I'm like, cool, and I just ran with it, bro. You know what I'm saying? With the baby mama bandit name, but. It's been crazy, bro. People hear that name, they be like, "Baby Mama Bandit." They instantly just catch on.
So I will to this day never forget that phrase. I damn near think you need to get it copyrighted.
I know, I need to.
At a certain point, like,
I need to for sure, bro.
Because like, that's the move for you.
Yeah,
bro.
Even right now, people are like, "Oh, that Baby Mama Bandit red, oh, bro. Like your baby mama." So it started off as a joke, and then it just, you know what I'm saying, it just rolled from there. So people was just attached to it.
All right, let's switch it up one more time. You pay attention to the NBA at all?
Oh, yeah, hell yeah, for sure, bro.
So, who's winning it this year?
Man, I don't know, man. I know everybody got the Lakers or the Clippers winning it. You already know we want the Bucks to take it all away.
I never heard. I guess me being in Milwaukee, I didn't hear one person say either of them teams.
Like,
I don't even listen to nobody that don't say outside of the Bucks. Like, we don't even fuck with them.
Yeah, man, you know, so we want the Bucks to win, man, but it can go either way. You know what
I
know? I think the Blazers, man, gonna give.
They've been playing really good ever since it came back up and shit.
Been crazy, bro. So,
what's the finals? What's the finals then for you?
Finals, man. I don't see nobody in the East beating the Bucks, so I'm going with Bucks and Lakers.
Man, Giannis versus fucking LeBron, that shit would be legendary.
Giannis,
I fuck with LeBron too, but not when it comes against the home city.
Oh man, you already know, man. We going Bucks all the way, so I'm predicting Bucks and Lakers.
All right, are you excited about the NFL season coming back?
NFL, you know what, bro? I ain't really been messing with the NFL like that.
Nah.
Man. Nah, bro. But you know what, though? I just seen that, what's the guy? He was a rookie. He just tried to sneak a chicken.
Okay, so hold up. You're fucking up my questions, bro. So the Seattle Seahawks player.
Yeah, yeah.
Puts a jersey on this young lady.
Yeah.
Brings her into a hotel.
Yeah.
And gets cut because he got caught.
Oh man!
So I was just like, what would the baby mama bandit do in that situation?
Man, I you know I ain't messing up no money, bro. And I'm not even like on the team. He was like trying to make the team.
He was still trying to make the team.
Whatever it takes. Like money first, baby mama bandit after. Like he was on some serious. He the real baby mama bandit. He was on some serious shit. that man was serious.
You ain't lying, bro. That's wild to think of doing though. I don't know. Yeah. Personally, I couldn't. I ain't fucking up the bag for nothing.
No, hell no, I ain't either.
All right, so Tory Lanez shot at Meg Stallion.
Man,
what's your opinions on that?
Man, that's crazy. It's crazy because we actually interviewed Tory Lanez like a long time ago on Black Star Radio. So, you know, what I'm saying we was trying to build a little relationship with him. But Tory, that's crazy. Like, I don't know, man. What was the reason though? Like, was he trying to leave him or something like that?
I heard they were arguing,
and he pulled a gun out.
And then shot it at the ground, and it ricocheted.
And hit her in the foot. Oh, my God.
Update from, like, a prior statement right. I had a few interviews ago.
And they said Tory, like, 4'8", so.
So that's the first thing I said, too. It's, like, it's a healthy-ass size.
Yeah,
difference.
You know what's crazy, though? Like people that's short, bro, they be having that, like, Napoleon syndrome or whatever they call it.
Yeah, the little man complex.
Yeah, bro, if you short, you be angry all the time.
I'm going to say it like this, though. Megan Thee Stallion could have put the hands to Tory Lanez. Because
she got the shit.
And she got the length, though, too.
Hell yeah, shit.
She got that John Jones reach, shit, so it's just like.
Shit, she motherfucking Deontay Wilder. She's 6'9". She got an 83-inch she reach, man.
Shit. All right, so speaking of 6'9".
Yeah.
How do you feel about him snitching and just being back to, like, being on top of the charts?
Shit, I knew it was going to happen. I knew it was going to happen. Like, for one, everybody knew he wasn't serious. The only people that thought he was serious was the actual Bloods that he was, like, with. And they probably didn't even think he was serious.
Bro. Yeah, so, I guarantee bro gave him money to protect him or something. Yeah, they just started fucking with him for no reason.
Yeah, so I'm pretty sure, like, I don't know, bro. Like, I kind of blame them for even putting him in that situation, like, with them. Like it's one thing to have him as an artist and y'all moving, but to actually, like, do shit with him, like, going out, shooting at niggas and doing different shit, bro, that shit was stupid as fuck, bro. I'd have never did that. But I knew he was going to get out of me popping, bro. I knew that already. This new generation, they don't care about snitching or none of that, bro. Like,
yeah, that shit's crazy
like
to me.
He getting money. Like, dog, walking New York with security. He a troll, bro. He the ultimate troll. I think he funny, bro. Like I think he funny as hell. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, 6ix9ine, he fucking funny. I don't personally listen to his music or no shit like that, but it'd be funny. It'd be funny, though, when I'm DJing, and, like, I literally have people asking me, like, can you play 6ix9ine, Gooba? Can you do this? So it'd be like, should I play it? Fuck it, I'm going to play it. Like, I'm playing what the people want, bro. So.
I mean, as a DJ, that's, yeah. I mean, so. I guess. If the people want them, you gotta give the people what they want.
What would you do though? Like you DJing, somebody be like, man, play 6ix9ine. You like, fuck it. You like, fuck 6ix9ine.
Nah, I'd be like, bitch, I got a playlist made. Get the fuck out of drunk ass away from me. But Red, you are a person of the people though. So
yeah,
you're a better person than famous. We're not gonna go into there.
But am I bumping them in my car while I'm driving? Nah, hell nah.
That's
I
crazy that people still.
Or I'm not playing them if you don't request them, I'm not gonna play them. You know what I'm saying? But if I get a person or two, like, I DJed last week. I had like two people like, hey, can you play 6ix9ine? Like, damn, I'm gonna play it. You know what I'm saying? So, but I know plenty of people that won't play it. Like, they don't give a fuck who requests it.
Yeah.
Like, you could be Jesus Christ. You know? I'm not playing your shit. So,
all right. Last but not least, where can we find you at?
Man, y'all can find me at your baby mama's house. Nah, fuck this.
Whoa.
Nah, look, you can find me, man, at
Lock her down.
At redwaukee.com, man. That's my website. That's redwaukee.com. Instagram, y'all can find me at worldwide_red. Shit. Twitter, same thing. Snapchat, babymama_bandit. Make sure y'all follow me, man. You know what I mean? I got some crazy stories, man. When I was in LA at a show, it was, oh my God. Y'all wouldn't follow me on Snapchat for that.
No, we gonna bring you back for another interview.
Yeah,
you know, like, we gonna have to.
I got a story for you. That LA story is crazy, famous. You gotta hear that.
Or we're gonna end it with maybe we'll have to have a story time with Red where we give bro a few sessions just to let him talk his shit.
Yeah, hell yeah, for sure, bro. But man, make sure y'all follow me, man. Worldwide_red. Snapchat, babymama_bandit, man. That's where I'm at.
All right, my man. Much love, family.
Man, thank you, bro. Appreciate it.